Welcome to On the Spot, and thank you for joining us. I am Kwamcheti Makoha. As exiled former governance PS John Githongo continues to make revelations about the Anglo leasing scandal, we return to an older scandal in which the country lost billions of shillings. With me in the studio is Mr. Kamlesh Pattni, a man who would like to be known as a generous philanthropist, but has been indicted by a judicial commission of inquiry as a principal architect of the multi-billion shilling Goldenberg scandal. Welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
Later we shall be taking a poll where the question is, has the government acted correctly by ordering fresh investigations into Goldenberg? SMS your responses to the numbers on your screen. Later we shall also take some of your calls. Mr. Pattni, what do you think of the conclusion by the Bosire Commission that you are the key suspect in the Goldenberg scandal? You almost single-handedly brought down the economy of this country. How do you feel about that?
Thank you for inviting me, Mr. Makoa. And I'm here because I want the truth to still continue. What I think about the report, from what I've seen on the TV and what I've read in the papers, is that the report is not at all correct, because the report is totally, because I saw the chairman speaking when presenting the report. He spoke Pattni.
Sir, tell me, how much money was lost in Goldenberg? Was it 60 billion, 100 billion, 20 billion?
According to me, I have all the documents here.
That's a fairly simple question. How much money was lost?
From Goldenberg itself, it was a genuine business.
The involvement of the Central Bank of Kenya with Goldenberg International lost this country some amount of money.
Yes.
Now, how much was it?
The money which was lost was by Central Bank through these other dubious banks like Trade Bank, Pan-African Bank, which banks were used by the Central Bank that time.
How much money was it, sir?
They lost, what was lost was 6.3 billion in Pan-African, and in Trade Bank about 5 billion.
That makes 11?
11. But as far as Goldenberg is concerned, what Goldenberg got was legitimately applied for in writing. There was no gun kept on any treasury official or governor. There was no theft of even a penny. Everything is documented.
So how is it that the Central Bank, a commission of inquiry, sits for 3 years, finds that 20 billion shillings is lost, and you insist that it's just 11 billion shillings?
But you are talking of a commission of inquiry of three people. If I tell you about public accounts committee,
there were hundreds of lawyers, 100, over 100 witnesses.
Mr. Makoa, please give a chance, because God has sent me here to speak. If you cut me short, it won't be right. We talk about Public Accounts Committee, where 13 members of parliament sat, including Leitwa Malwa and Shikuku. And they were humble enough to come to see my factory of gold and diamonds. And their finding is there, which was passed through the parliament. Now, we cannot harp about a commission of inquiry which has done a biased report and impartial. The commission was sworn to be impartial and faithful and truthful. But I will prove to this country that they have been totally partial and unfaithful. And I say this because the commission did not give me a chance to say what I wanted.
You were on the stand for almost 60 days.
In
60 days, you couldn't quite say what you wanted to say, sir?
I was on the stand under a fake murder charge, which was hatched and conspired at that commission. And I've got the proof. It was under that chairmanship. They conspired a murder charge to make sure that my hands are tied and that my mouth is controlled.
Okay, now you don't have a murder charge hanging over you. What is the truth?
The truth is that I presented all the things. I said what the previous leadership, because I was not the president at that time, I was not governor, I was not a minister, anything in this. I have said it plainly that it was the leadership of the government at that time who had all these things done with the governor of Central Bank, and I have mentioned all the facts there. And the commission went out of its way. When I said money was given, they called whole Central Bank with 5 million cash, with a bag I had not even approved, with a bag, and said, stuff it here. What was the commission doing?
Fine.
Acting as a lawyer,
sir,
for those people?
I follow your point.
Yes.
I follow your point.
Correct.
You are saying the country lost money through Goldenberg. You are saying also that it was not you. So who is it that lost the country this money?
The country lost money through those banks, Pan-African Bank, where I've shown shareholder certificates. Who were shareholders there?
They were
the previous regime.
Who else?
They lost to Trade Bank, which was under control of the governor at that time.
Okay.
And they lost billions through that. Then they use my legitimate business.
Who are these?
And my innocence to put it on my head.
Who are these, sir?
Sorry?
Who are they?
I have mentioned
clearly.
Who are
the owners of Trade Bank? Who are the owners of Pan-African Bank?
Pan-African Bank was the late Aslam. And the ex-president was also a shareholder. I have shown the certificate. And also, there were other shareholders there. And the Trade Bank was Al-Nur Qasim and others. When the chairman is presenting the report, he says, Trade Bank, we lost so many billion. Why doesn't say Al-Nur Qasim? But he says, Pattni. Who am I? I'm a human being. And let us, I'm not, because I have said this and very clearly, those who are redeemed and born again shall be bound by fear of nothing.
Sir, at the commission, you are described as a forger, a liar, a perjurer. Why should anyone believe you?
First of all, may God forgive, because they know
what proof,
no, they
what
don't
proof
know
do
what
have,
they are talking.
What proof do you have to back the statements you're making that the central bank lost this money through Aslam and through these other people who own Trade Bank, the former president, for example?
I have given all the proof there. I have given agreements. I have given central bank documents. I have given reports.
What are these documents?
They have not even looked at it. You see, it is a preconceived. It is a pity that the government, the new government, tried and appointed a commission which they thought would be impartial and faithful. And here, it's like they've flushed 400 million down the drain.
Let me take you back. Money was lost. Where was it? Who was it lost to? Was it lost to individuals? Was it lost to institutions?
It was lost for the 92 election, multi-party.
It was used in the 92 elections.
You know what
elections.
Happened in multi-party?
It was used in the 92 elections.
In 92 elections, and by the powers who were there at that time.
What proof do you have of that?
I have all the proof which I have given. I have given original documents.
Did you?
Of the election documents.
Did you support political activity with financing?
Yes, I said that the president that time asked for a loan for the election, and it was there, and I've said
how much
it.
Did you give?
But you see,
the former president.
I've said it was 4.2 billion for the election.
You gave 4.2 billion shillings to KANU?
Yes, that time.
Did you fund anyone else?
Well, I have funded, like a normal businessman, other parties. Like that time,
how much did
Ford
you give
Kenya,
Ford Kenya?
Ford Kenya was only about 2 million.
2 million. How
yes.
much did you give the Democratic Party?
No, I did not.
Did you give any to Ford Asili?
Ford Asili, no.
So what was deciding which party you are going to fund and which one you are not going to fund?
It's the one who approaches. If they approach you, that is when. But you see, I have, all these facts which I have given are all been called a lie, and you cannot have a report which is based on bias and on one side, which we are going to call it a truthful report. Then I will say, let us rely on a public accounts committee where 13 members of parliament sat, and you know, I was locked up. I was locked up on a fake murder charge. And that murder charge originated from that commission. And I'm ready to challenge it.
But before that, Mr. Pattni, you've been charged in court numerous times with forgery, with obtaining money by false pretenses. These cases have been going on for 14 years, and you are able to run, you and your lawyers were able to run rings around the judicial system for 14 years.
Again, may God forgive you for saying that. I've been charged. I was charged for murder. And the DPP that I made this country to believe that this is a murderer. And what is the outcome? To be charged, any vindictive person can do that. Any person with vengeance can do that. Where is the proof that I'm a murderer or I'm a, what you are calling those charges? You see, I was ready, always ready, from 1994 when I was first charged. On 2nd June 1994, I was charged for 13.5 billion, 5.8 billion, CGE what billion? And then drama and drama. Go through the trial. I was halfway through the trial. Suddenly, they change. The Chunga is made Chief Justice, and that time Chief Magistrate really in the case is made DPP. Well, I'm not young forever. I'm a mortal. And in this world, we are all mortals, and we are all aging. Let us sit down round. I have been so honest and truthful that I have not run away like Alnur Qasim with all those billions. I have got agreements here from Central Bank, which were signed by Mika Chesirem. And these agreements show every penny is accounted for. I sat here to account for every penny because my heart is clean and I am not a thief.
Hold that thought. We'll take a short break, and when we come back, we will begin to discuss with Mr. Pattni what exactly he wanted to do with Goldenberg. Don't go away.
Are you looking for a job? In your Daily Nation, this Friday and every Friday is the Nation Job Scan, featuring hundreds of jobs from every sector and industry for both potential employees and employers. Make sure you get your copy of the Daily Nation this Friday for job opportunities beyond your wildest dreams. Nation Job Scan, your guide to a successful career.
On the next episode of First Monday.
Oh, abortion cases gets everybody testy, especially Esther.
An abortion doctor is gunned down.
Oh my God!
Why are you so damn adamant to hear a case you're not taking a position on?
I believe it's our duty to give the country constitutional direction.
While a judge's life is hanging in the balance.
We'll also have federal marshals keeping an eye on your family for a few days.
That won't be necessary.
Yes, it is.
We have had three federal judges assassinated in the last 20 years. In dangerous times, we ought to clamp down on dangerous talk.
First Monday, Sunday night on NTV.
Okay.
Welcome back. Remember, you can SMS your answer to our poll question tonight. Has the government acted correctly by ordering fresh investigations into Goldenberg? SMS your answer to the numbers on your screen. Mr. Pattni, you say you wanted to make Kenya a prosperous country. You wanted to make it the Switzerland of Africa. What went wrong?
I wanted to make Kenya like most of this Dubai and Hong Kong and all this country where there is no poverty. Poverty is minimal.
Yes, what went wrong? You wanted to gather all the diamonds that are being smuggled in here and export them legally. What went wrong?
Kenya is surrounded by mineral-rich countries.
That's true.
And this idea of which was brought by Goldenberg was discussed from 1986 under that time Oyugi was in OP. That time, Honorable Nyachai was the chief secretary. It was discussed by Treasury and many reports have been done on that. Then, when I moved to Nairobi, is when I said that this is the business which can make Kenya independent of begging all the time for an exchange.
Just tell us what went wrong.
What went wrong is that a noble idea started by me. Started to see billions of shilling coming into the country, and then the eyes opened. And this is that time the government at that time, you know, usurped and dumped all their messes on my Goldenberg.
Who in government usurped your project?
I've mentioned them. I said it starts from the leadership at that time, the governor
who,
of Central
exactly?
Bank.
Exactly. The leadership was about 200 people.
The then President Moi.
President Moi.
Then
governor.
Joshua Kulei.
President Moi's personal assistant, yes.
Yes, then the governor of Central Bank, Kotut. And the people, those are the main, and of course there were others there.
Did any of these people make money personally out of this scam?
Yes, they made, and I've given the proof.
How much money did each one of them make?
I've shown checks, you know, sent to the lawyer Akbar Ismail for Kulei's, and he has written that. Nothing is considered. I've sent the proof of payments which were made for the elections and all that. And I've shown that how 6.3 billion was removed from Pan African Bank. And then I only came to find the hole there.
How much money did you make yourself out of this project of exporting diamonds and gold?
The money I made is all tabulated there. It's the compensation.
How much was it?
It was about if you count the whole that was 6.7 less. So it was about 800-900 million.
You did not make a billion out of this?
No. Look at the
facts. Who made the billions?
The billions were gone into the elections and all this.
Now, you say that you gave the elections 4.2 billion to KANU and 2 million
yes.
to Ford Kenya.
Correct.
Where's the balance? Where's the 16 billion or the 96 billion if you are working with Melville Smith's figures of 100 billion?
Melville Smith was not a...
You did not write anyone a check.
Was not a gospel truth.
You did not write anyone a check for 50 million, 50 billion, did
there
you?
Is no those billions which have been said there. Yet.
So where did this money disappear?
Even if you look at the report, you can see there is 13.5, there is 5.8, and here are the figures. They are all here. Mr. Mika Chesrim, the new governor who came, he said it on the other day in the TV that if Pattni gave me 1 shilling, I shall go to committee, and he's right. He put me under special branch. He put me under CID, and even charged the Grand Regency.
Yes, what
so
you are
every
showing
penny
me, what,
is
what you're showing me, what you're showing me is an agreement between yourself and the.
read a statement from the accused for the commission. The accused refused to make, my brother-in-law refused to make statement, but they go and arrest, lock them up. Come to the people mentioned now, there is a court order, call these VIPs, call all these people. What does commission say? No. That is voluntarily. Why arrest two Indians? Because they are helpless? Are they the children of a lesser god and those are children of a superior god? This is the harassment.
Let's go to the second question.
Yes.
Why did you choose Kenya?
Shaban is saying, why did you choose Kenya? Kenya is the Switzerland of this region. Kenya has got infrastructure. Kenya has got international airports and everything. Kenya has got local industries, which our neighboring does not have local industry. So I wanted gold and diamond to come. We sell local goods in barter. So this country would have another 100 industries and so many jobs had
okay.
they
point
followed
made,
this.
Point made. Let's take the next call. Hello? Hello?
Hello.
Yes, please state your name, please, and your question or comment.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Yeah, please state your question, ma'am. Go ahead.
Yes. My question is, I'm Steve Ringera. My question is to Paul, who is claiming to be a born-again Christian. And now that Kenya is facing so many problems and there is still all that money they are talking about, I would like to ask him if the Kenyans are expecting Bwana Pattni to return any money, at least to clear his conscience at the moment.
Next call. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, please.
I'm Washington from Makadara.
Yes, Washington.
Yes, I would just like to ask one question. It is impossible for one man by the name Kamlesh Pattni to defraud the government or the Kenyan people with those billions of shillings. And at that particular time, we have the governor of the central bank and we have the systems of government working. I think these people are just sacrificing this man for no reason.
Okay. Hello? Do you have another caller?
Yes, Ali.
Yes, please.
Okay, my name is Alice.
Yes, Alice.
I also want to say that before the Bosile inquiry, I also used to think that this man, Pattni, is very bad. But watching the proceedings and the witnesses and everything that was happening there, my conclusion was that he was just a sacrificial ram.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Do we have another caller on the line? Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Yes, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Yes, my name is Miss Fernandez.
Yes, Miss Fernandez.
I just have a question for Mr. Pattni.
Yes.
That we read the commission spent 2 years and 30 million shillings to do the report and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And that only three people have been recommended to be prosecuted, but there were so many names mentioned. And they were cleared of doing no wrong. I wanted to ask him, you know, what does he have to say about this? And because we followed the whole commission, we realized was Mr. Bosir and everybody were trying to protect the previous president. Were they trying to act like his lawyers? Or because there's a lot of bias we could see.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Pattni, I want to connect that question with another one that I had here. When you got into trouble, did you try to get help from the people you'd been helping, especially the former president?
Yes.
What happened?
You see, it was like when King Saul was sick, David used to play music to make him feel happy.
What happened?
He served. Then it was King Saul himself who was trying to kill David. What happened is that as long as I was useful, as long as there was no pressure from my family.
Did the former president talk to you and tell you, I will not help you?
Yes, he called. Mr. Kotut came to
you call him?
Mr. Kotut came to my house in Kitusuru.
Yes.
I had a hotline to the state house and to president's bedroom.
Yes.
So he, at the same time, president called, the ex-president, and he said, Fanya vile Kotut anasema.
Okay. But when you got into trouble.
Yes, now I'm coming to it, my friend. Let me, if you cut me short, it will escape.
We don't have too much time.
But you see, the fury of a king, be aware of the fury of a king. He was the king, the sitting president. And king is chosen by the Lord. It's Lord's blessing is there. So I said, yes, sir. Sign this, charge sign. Do this, do that. Then from that day, the hotlines went dead. Na sacrifice Pattni. So I could not call him. I sent people. Akuna. When I used to sit every day, literally two, three times a week, at his house at Cabernet Garden. I mean, nobody should, you know, do such a thing to a human being. Because we are all equal before the eye of the God.
Okay, so how was it possible, the second question, how was it possible for one man to defraud an entire government?
Which one man?
You.
It's not possible. You are answering the question you're asking. It's impossible. I was not in any... Unless, of course, let this commission say that I went with a gun, or I break into the central bank, or I have every document. I have come here. I have not broken into the nation house. I'm telling you, you have not put a gun behind anywhere here. I'm speaking with my own will. You are getting this. This is exactly the story.
Do you plan to return any of the money?
That is a question the first caller asked. It's not that I plan to. I have written during the Moi government, I have agreements here out of court settlement, which their lawyer, Mr. Murgor, spoiled, made sure it doesn't go through because he demanded 200 million fees to be paid first.
What was the gist of the agreement? What was the gist of the out of court agreement?
The out of court agreement is the legitimate agreement signed by Governor Mr. Chesrem of CBK, which is clearing every penny I've accounted for. I even sold some of my jewelries and which was left there. I even scratched and sold
You are repaying whatever debts you owed the central bank.
And what was the balance remaining? I gave them a charge of Grand. And that
of
Grand Regency Hotel.
Right.
They took it. And then I said, look, this charge you are taking by force, it is temporary. Because if you account 6.3 billion of Power African, it is you people who have stolen, not me. And then when we come to the new government in 2004, January, my lawyer wrote to Honorable, to the Minister of Finance, that time was Muraria, and said, our client is ready to sit round the table and pay what is due and account for it. And here is the reply we got, said, wait for the commission to be over. So a thief does not sit around the table. A thief does not build a Grand Regency
Hotel. Okay, Mr. Pattni, we'll take a short break. Remember, you can SMS your answer to our poll question this evening. And the question is, has the government acted correctly by ordering fresh investigations into Goldenberg? SMS your answer to the lines on your screen.
On the next episode of Soul Food.
You guys still having drama?
Is it that obvious? I think I'm gonna have to go by the shop and get a cut.
Oh, what you need to cut is the bullshit, brother.
Excuse me?
Tempers will flare.
Yeah, whatever.
Did you lose your job because you were too busy letting Malik turn you out?
Will anything good come out of a bad situation?
I don't need your help.
Soul Food, Friday night on NTV.
The gift.
My mistress says the pig cannot come in, but the animal will take.
From the director of Chocolat, how far will one legend go to become the man?
Let's start by taking one step closer to heaven.
One woman always dreamed of.
I'm in love with you, Francesca.
Casanova.
Buy fuel worth 2,000 shillings at selected Kenol Kobil stations in Nairobi and get movie tickets for you and your loved one to watch Casanova on Valentine's Day.
Kenol Kobil cares for you.
Welcome back. I'm with Mr. Pattni on the spot. Mr. Pattni, there were claims during the Bosire Commission of Inquiry that tapes had been confiscated from your residence. Where are these tapes and what did they contain?
That's another good question. There were claims that tapes had been confiscated. But I say, do not judge your brother harshly, yet you shall be judged by the same standards. And look, there were no tapes, but look who has tapes today. Mr. Githongo has tapes. And those are the people who are saying, tapes, Tapes. Where is the tape? Show me the first tape.
Talking about Mr. Githongo, in retrospect, do you feel that you should have recorded some of the things that happened?
Mine is a clean heart. I'm not a special brand. I'm not a traitor. I'm not an evil doer. And I see no need to record anybody.
But you also had an elaborate list of people you had given payouts. And that came out of the commission. Isn't there a contradiction there?
No. There's no contradiction. Elaborate list of payout is what the account, the cashier was keeping. Naturally, in accounts, there is always accountability. And those were names which were there, and I've explained them in the commission.
Did you at any time feel that your life was in danger?
Yes. My life was in danger so many times.
From
but
whom?
My protector is God.
Where was the source of the danger? How did you feel that your life was in danger?
Well, I was told that because the information that I was going to testify in the commission. I said that I don't need any, I will say the truth and the God is my protector.
Did anyone threaten you?
There was, yes, some threatening calls to my operator and them. And I don't know, the threatening person will not say, I am Mr. So-and-so, and this is my address, and this is my phone number. It's just a call. But there were those things, and I was not afraid. Because when you are with the one who is in you is greater than the one in the world. So you shall not fear mortals.
It's obvious you are very well connected, Mr. Pattni. Even when you are on a murder charge and in remand, you actually spend the entire time in hospital, in a military hospital. How do you manage to do these things?
Mr. Makoa, it doesn't take connection to be in a hospital. If you are sick, the laws of the Prison Act, I didn't bring it, but you can read it.
And
it is provided for.
And you seem to have recovered as soon as you are freed.
Mr. Makoa, if you are charged for murder which you have not committed, thank God that my brain is okay and my heart did not get a heart attack. I was locked and then I'm being told. You see, this is why I say, do not judge your brother harshly, yet you'll be judged by same standard. There comes people that, we have locked you because you will run away. Oh, we have locked because you will disappear. Who has run away? Mr. Githongo has run away or I have run away? Why do you judge?
Yes.
Because I'm a mortal of a lesser God. You think you can only judge that I will run away?
One of the fears during the course of the Goldenberg Commission of Inquiry was that you are going to flee. And your passport was impounded. Has it been returned to you?
Of course. The passport was returned as soon as the murder charge was... I was vindicated, clear of murder charge. I have traveled after that to Kinshasa. I have traveled to Tanzania.
Okay.
I have traveled to Dubai.
All that thought will take
and
a
that
call.
And the fear you are telling is a perceived fear, which
okay.
is from
Let's
the wicked
call.
And the
Let's
evil.
Let's take a call, Mr. Pattni. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Yeah. I have a comment to make about
Your name, please?
Pattni.
Yes.
My name is Debbie.
Yes.
How could one man be probed for so long by the government and they don't find any, nothing is found about the guy. One guy is charged in 1986 or 1994. The same guy is charged by a different government in 2000. And the same guy is charged again in 2004. What is wrong? Is it the government or the person? Is it the government that we are going through changes of government, or is it the person?
Hello. Okay. Thanks. Hello. Is there another caller?
Yeah. My name is Kerubo.
Yes, Kerubo.
Yeah. My question is directed to Mr. Pattni. The export compensation scheme came into being when our country had no foreign reserve. It worked as motivation for genuine exporters to go out and market Kenyan products. The scheme was completely exhausted and eventually abolished because of you, Mr. Pattni, and Mr. Saitoti. Are there moments in your conscience, Mr. Pattni, when you feel guilty that you brought 30 million Kenyans and their economy to their knees?
Hello, let's take the second caller. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, please. State your name and your question, sir. Oh, sorry. Okay. Mr. Pattni, very, very clear. You forced the country to abandon a scheme of encouraging Kenyans to export. How do you feel about that? Do you feel any guilt?
Well, this is what the caller is saying and what you are saying. And what you two are saying is not the truth.
You have no...
No gospel
you have,
truth.
You have no...
I have... Yes.
You have no guilt. You have no remorse.
No remorse because my conscience is clear.
How can what your conscience I did, be clear when the entire scheme was abolished?
Okay, look at Zimbabwe today. There is no electricity because they don't have foreign exchange to pay for it. What I've done is I've saved this country. The hardship they would have seen, they've never seen. And one day, as we are sitting, in the near future, you will see they will need me again to earn this country.
Mr. Pattni, you quote the Bible a lot, and
yes.
I'm going to quote it once to you.
Please.
There was one fellow called Zacchaeus,
yes.
Terrible tax collector,
correct.
Thief.
Yes.
When he repented,
yes.
and decided to follow Jesus,
yes.
he gave up all his wealth and said, I got this illegally, and I'm giving it back.
Yes.
Where's your gesture? Where is your gesture of honesty?
My gesture of honesty is that Zacchaeus, I've written this letter to the treasury. I've said, we sit down.
And you, yes.
You see, what is happening now is there is...
In that letter, Mr. Pattni, in that letter you have offered to pay the treasury
correct.
800 million shillings.
The balance is, yes, correct.
800 million shillings. Treasury
yes.
is saying they lost 20 billion shillings.
But
it's a drop in the water.
If they lost that, let us see the facts. You can't say... The Treasury has not said, Mr. Makoa, let us not put words in the mouth of Treasury. It is this commission report. I don't know whether it say 20 billion or what, but they have not considered all the... I told you that this commission, the same person who was sitting there, the DPP that time, in that commission, he goes and charges me for murder, which you people, at that time, I'm sure you believed I'm a murderer. Today, and then what came out? The same commission today is saying that, accusing me of theft. You want to believe it? When they have been wrong in the murder? What is bigger than a murder? Let us not just clap to hear juicy things.
Back again to the question that was asked by the lady, Davis, I think. Why would two administrations want to pursue one man for so long? 13, 14 years? Why you? Why not me? Why not somebody else?
Which administration you are saying?
The Moi government. Arrested you and charged you.
Yes.
You had several law cases.
I explained you why.
And now this administration...
Sacrifice me.
Yes, now this administration, what need does this administration have to sacrifice you?
But where this administration... We are just talking of the report which is out. There are investigations going on. They have not charged.
You have been indicted.
But by the commission.
Yes.
By the commission and of three people who I said they have... They have biased. They did not call even, they did not allow my re-examination. A commission who was acting like a lawyer for some of those VIPs, calling cash to be stuffed in a bag. Why didn't they go to check, ask the recipient whether he received 5 million or not? Which is easier, to call 100 security from and stuff the money? Or why did they refuse my invitation? I told the chairman, Mr. Bosire, chairman, I humbly request, please come to my factory and see the machines, which even a whole public account saw. He said, no, we are not interested. What is the truth then?
Mr. Pattni, if you are found guilty, are you prepared to go to jail?
Yes, if I am found guilty, then I am ready to face any consequence.
But no action seems to be taking place. Are Kenyans, you've dealt with this system for a very long time. Are Kenyans naive to expect that there is going to be any action on corruption?
You see, it's not naive or not. The system that time was just, as I say, sacrificing selectively. And that now, because there was no truth, there was no evidence, even now there isn't. I've said that even this report, which has been presented, is not worth the paper it is written on. And I shall prove it. I'm ready. I even said, I'm saying it here and on record, I'm ready to write any statement and to cooperate with the investigation to the fullest and speak the truth.
What do you think will ultimately come out at the end of this investigation?
when I went to the commission, I said that it is the truth which shall set you free. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Now I am saying, if the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. What will come out is what the will of God says, is I am innocent.
You say you are a Christian. You spoke for many days at the commission. And yet this country is not anywhere near the truth about what happened around the Goldenberg scandal.
Now,
what do you, as a Kenyan born and raised in Kisumu, as a Christian, what is your contribution to helping this country deal with this corruption problem?
I was born in Mombasa. So I was born in Kisumu. May I correct you?
Okay.
And here you are saying, now you are coming to agree with me, that truth was not found. It's because the commission, which was trusted to be impartial and faithful,
what is
has
truth?
Written a completely
what is the truth?
Report which I will show by facts, by papers, not by words. I'm saying, yeah, this is a TV station. If it is a court of law, I'll show. So what I'm saying is I will stand by the truth and help this government or any government to bring out the truth. I will cooperate with any investigating branch, anybody, to bring the truth to this saga. Because I'm innocent and my heart is saying that my conscience is clear that I'm not guilty.
Okay, I mean, what is the connection between money and politics? Why is it that, and I was asking you this earlier, why is it that it's always Asian businessmen? Why do they find it easier to get to start doing deals with the government?
The Indian people all over the world are not, it's not a secret, are known to be very aggressive traders. And even in London, some of them have a pharmacy shop and they work till midnight while the others close at 5. So it is just in their genes. And I cannot, but from my side, I can only speak that I had a noble cause to help this country with foreign exchange. And I'm still going to do it, Mr. Makoa. I have the application here which I've done to EPZ.
Mr. Pattni, I shall bring gold.
You can come and see with your Nation TV there how much gold.
We've run out of time, Mr. Pattni.
It's coming.
Now we need to take a look at our poll results for the evening. And the question was, has the government acted correctly by ordering fresh inquiries into the Goldenberg scandal? The results of the poll, yes, 14%, no, an overwhelming 86%. Mr. Pattni, and perhaps as you make your closing remarks, if another brilliant young man like yourself walked into the central bank today, what is the chance that they would make away with 20 billion like you did? As you make your closing remarks.
As I make my closing remark, let me tell you that I never went away with any billion. I won't be sitting here if I went with those billion. I'll be in Hawaii or in Honolulu by the yacht in the sea. And there is still, because you see, when this government has come in, there are still holes everywhere. And as long as the holes are there, rats will come in and we'll be shouting, oh, there are rats. We need to strengthen the institutions. We need to seal those with sand and cement and water. And that sand and cement and water is the constitution and the laws to be enacted. See, that is what I'm saying, that as long as that what governor could do that time, anybody can do, it is still there.
Mr. Pattni, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Viewer, as it's become apparent, understanding the Goldenberg scandal is something that is probably going to take more than one evening. But we hope that you continue to keep the pressure on as we wait for the investigations into this and other scandals. From us at NTV, it's good night. Good evening, and welcome to your live interactive talk show On the Spot. I'm your host, Kwamchetsi Makoha. The fight against corruption and constitution review, those are the two great challenges facing Kenya today. With me in the studio tonight is a renowned political activist, human rights activist, renowned lawyer, and the Minister for Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Ms. Martha Karua. Welcome, madam.
Thank you.
As our discussion continues, we shall be taking a poll. The question is the government's promise on speedy prosecutions sincere? SMS your answer to the numbers on your screen. Later in the program, we shall also be coming to you and open our phone line so that you can call in with your questions to the minister. Madam, February has been a terrible month for the government. There have been three cabinet resignations, and the president's private secretary has been fired. How do you feel about this?
I do not consider February a particularly bad month for the government. I think there has been developments which as Kenyans we should appreciate. The three resignations from cabinet should be seen in the positive light that here are three